Imagine an alternate world where dinosaurs evolved intelligence comparable to a human's. What might these intelligent dinosaurs look like? What kind of technology, culture, and art might they produce? This speculative timeline is the subject of Dinosauroids, a world-building project conceptualized in part by C.M. Kosemen, whose work you may know from his sci-fi book All Tomorrows, or from his speculative paleontology book All Yesterdays, the latter of which I've got a video on elsewhere in the archive. Dinosauroids also comes from Simon Roy, an accomplished comic book artist and writer who created much of the art you'll see in this video. These two are outstanding creators, and I have links to where you can follow and support them in this video's description. The Dinosauroids project was born in part out of Kosemen's and Roy's frustration with the work of paleontologist Dale Russell, who, in 1982, created this concept of how a species like a troodon might evolve into an upright walking bipedal organism with human-like intelligence. While the depiction has a retro vibe I find kind of entertaining, it's a pretty old-fashioned and human-centric model of an intelligent dinosaur. So Kosemen and Roy created their own, more scientifically viable models which don't look much like humans, but have all the right ingredients for human-like intelligence. So for this entry into the archive, we'll explore the incredibly detailed speculative world and history Roy and Kosemen created to go alongside these new dinosaurs. They even imagine, incredibly, the art these creatures might produce, which we'll get into later in the video. With that said, let's begin. In the hypothetical alternate timeline of Dinosauroids, there was no end Cretaceous asteroid impact, nor did any other cataclysm befall the non-avian dinosaurs. Kosemen and Roy theorize that even without a mass extinction, dinosaur groups would have kept evolving into new, unfamiliar forms. For now, let's focus on the dinosauroids themselves, and explore how the authors speculate they might have first evolved. The species, they imagine, originated from troodon-like ancestors. The development of their advanced intelligence and early use of tools likely began slowly. While the very image of a bird-like species using primitive spears might seem surprising to some, various modern birds, in particular crows, which inspired the look of dinosauroids, are highly intelligent, and have indeed been seen using simple tools and solving logical puzzles. In this experiment from the University of Auckland, you can see a crow using stones to gain access to submerged food, showing an impressive understanding of water displacement in the process. So the idea of a bird-like dinosaur achieving advanced intelligence through a similar foundation isn't too outside the realm of possibility. This image illustrates the two species of intelligent dinosaurs on this alternate Earth, both of which diverge from a troodon-like ancestor. While the idea of multiple intelligent species living on one planet at the same time might seem surprising, it's not too far off from our own history with humans and Neanderthals. The hypothetical scientific designations of the two dinosauroids are Avosapiens sauropteus and Avosapiens tetarchus. And while both species make frequent use of their beaks for tool use, they also seem to have complex hands with dexterous fingers, a feature that could allow them to make use of delicate tools and evolve brain function analogous to a human's. Aside from the dinosauroids, the authors designed an extensive ecosystem of animals around the titular species. While most of these dinosaurs are descendants of the Maniraptoran group, Kosemen and Roy also populated this hypothetical world with various species of mammals, which have managed to grow into large and sophisticated forms just like in our time, despite the presence of dinosaurs. Due to the butterfly effect, however, these mammals would of course be different from the species we're familiar with, even if there are some parallels. One entertaining example of a new species is the Megatopyrus, a large herbivore that superficially resembles an elephant due to the honing force of convergent evolution. A neat idea. The authors also imagine a variety of mammalian carnivores that somewhat resemble canine predators. These mammals are far from the largest organisms patrolling this hypothetical world, however, which still very much belongs to the dinosaurs. On the subject of dinosaurs, the authors wanted pterosaurs to fill various niches. Since these species were already in decline by the time of the asteroid's impact, however, Kosemen and Roy have imagined them dwindling down to just a few subspecies, comparable to storks and other large water birds. In terms of larger dinosaurs, we have the aptly named classification of the Avititans, massive, lumbering herbivores that are the largest new organisms on this alternate Earth. Another large species is the bullbird, a wary and dangerous scavenger that stalks the plains of the Eurasian continent. Kosemen and Roy imagined that hunting bullbirds was a rite of passage for early dinosauroids, who needed to coordinate with each other to take the beasts down. Some hunters enlisted the help of jackalbirds, hawk-like species that the dinosauroids, inventively, managed to domesticate, just like early humans and the ancestor of the modern dog. But dinosauroids and their domestic pets aren't the only hunters on the plains. These are the Tyrannoraptors, a species of hypothetical theropods whose evolution echoes that of none other than the massive-jawed Tyrannosaurus rex. This dangerous predator is also known by the dinosauroids as Black Thing, and are the largest predators in this imagined dominion. In order to survive in this dangerous world, dinosauroids, the creators speculate, have had to rely on their technological cunning much like early humans. Here you can see a dinosauroid with a carved stone tool in its mouth used for hunting. At this point in the speculative timeline, most tribes of dinosauroids are nomadic, building temporary structures while migrating for protection from the elements. One detail I like is that these structures look a lot like the nests of modern birds, which, don't forget, are also descendants of theropods. The authors imagine that the dinosauroids do eventually form more permanent village-like settlements, which are intriguingly still made up of nest houses, just more sturdy ones. In these more permanent societies, early forms of intricate cultural expression might emerge, like this young artist painting on stretched animal skins using ground-up soil, as well as other natural pigments and a brush made from a wing feather. Pretty clever. Still, many dinosauroids maintain migratory lifestyles, like these two individuals with the domesticated form of bullbird mentioned previously, which is carrying their various supplies. Other dinosauroids travel light, like this mountaineering duo carrying weapons and travel gear themselves. Curiously, Roy and Kosemen mentioned their weapons are crafted from bronze, indicating the dinosauroids are emerging into a new phase of technological development. Many groups also seem to equip themselves with weaponized war masks, wooden helmet-like structures with obsidian blade edges to improve the striking power of their beaks. While these masked warriors look imposing, the authors imagine these masks, while intimidating, aren't actually the most practical. But dinosauroid society is clearly becoming more technologically proficient, inventing armaments like a unique spear-throwing device and primitive Bronze Age sets of armor. Clearly, the dinosauroids are, for better or worse, following our own path in many ways. But warfare isn't the only aspect of dinosauroid culture that Kosemen and Roy have fleshed out. The two have also created various images depicting what paintings by dinosauroids might look like. Take, for example, this painting depicting an Avititan family. Here, the broad, impressionistic strokes that are a trademark of the dinosauroid style are reflective of how they use feathers to apply paint. Or, take this stylized painting of a dinosauroid hunter spearing some four-legged mammal, an image which reminds me of early cave paintings our human ancestors created. Even more stylized, we have a mural of a warrior confronting a spirit creature. Here, you can see elements of myths and legends sneaking their way into the art, just as was the case with human cultural development. The dangerous, predatory Black Thing gets a similar treatment, with the organism's mouth and horns exaggerated in the artist's recreation, reflecting the parts of the animal that stood out the most to the dinosauroid creator. And beyond paintings, perhaps the dinosauroids might have also told spoken stories in their own bird-like languages. Here you can see a fireside chat between an elder and several hatchlings. Kosemen and Roy imagine this storyteller is weaving tales of spirits and other worlds, in particular a legend of a sky god which resembles a flying pterosaur. What a creative level of worldbuilding. Beyond these early societies, who knows what the future might have held for a species like the dinosauroids. Perhaps their technology would continue to develop, like this hypothetical sketch of a more heavily armored warrior which almost resembles a knight. And who knows, perhaps long into the hypothetical future, this species might even develop the technology necessary to become a space-faring civilization. It's a pretty interesting concept, although not one Kosemen and Roy have said they've pursued seriously. Still, the hypothetical future of the dinosauroids seems full of endless potential, although we've reached the end of our exploration for this particular video. If you like this world, please consider supporting Roy and Kosemen by patronizing their other works and social media, which as always you can find in the links below. And if you like this video, I have others covering the speculative work of CM Kosemen elsewhere in the archive. Also, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this entry, please lend your support, and like, subscribe, and hit the notification icon to stay up to date on all things curious. See you in the next video.